Okay, oops. All right, so let's start with the first one. So I just want to like review this about expressions. So what is an expression in math? So if you guys remember in the first or second week of the school year, we talk about algebra a little bit, not too much. Algebra is actually the extension of arithmetic. So it extends the tool of arithmetic. Arithmetic is basically four operations, like adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing, any kind of numbers. So algebra is kind of like a couple more extension, like it's going like a little bit further. So which were developed to work with numbers so they can be used to solve real world problems, okay? This require first, translating words from your everyday language. So in every statement, most of the time when those statements includes like a mathematical expressions, so you can rewrite them in a mathematical way. And we call that it's a translating words into symbols or numbers. And for example, you can do this with any language, English, Spanish, French, or any language. So we can model everyday life problems into mathematical problem. So this is what algebra mean actually. It's a math, but a little bit further of arithmetic. Okay, then those expressions can be operated on the tools originally developed for arithmetic. So this is the break it down. I break it down in this way. So an expression may contain a number, a variable, and mathematical operation. We always worked on numbers and mathematical operations a lot, not the variables. When you include the variables, it becomes expressions, okay? So those expressions, actually, it's a part of the algebra. And an example could be, it's a 4x plus 2. As you can see, like, there is a number, there is an operation, which is addition operation, and there is a variable. And between variable and number, there is a multiplication. So that's why it says an expression may contain numbers, variables, and mathematical operations, okay? So this is an example for algebraic expression. And the next slide, there is a about the terms. I think yesterday when you work on vocabulary, actually you became familiar with these terms, right? And the term is, the term of an expression are the parts of the expression. So term is actually part of the expression. So if your expression is 4x plus 2, there is a terms. So those are the parts of expression and which are separated by addition and subtraction, okay? So the plus and minus sign preceding a term not only connects the term to the expression, but is also part of the term. Also, if the first term is positive, then the plus sign is often omitted, means like you're not gonna see the plus sign if the terms are positive, okay? And but there's still a part of the term. And complete this chart that include the sign of each term. So what we talk about here, I'm gonna show you in these examples now. Let me grab my pencil. Just give me a second. Here we go, okay. So in here, like on the first one, the expression, as I said on the previous slide, it's a 4x plus 2, right? It contains variable, number, and operation. So terms are actually separated by addition or subtraction signs. So in this case, there are two terms, like 4x and 2. They are separated by this plus sign. So the first term will be the first of this expression, which is 4x. Most of the time, like we're not gonna put the plus sign. I put it here just to show you it's a positive term because it's a plus 4x. Most of the time, you're not gonna see the plus sign if it's positive. We omit them, like we're not gonna write a plus sign. It's a 4x, the first term. And the second term is just 2 itself. Number is also a term. It doesn't have to be a variable, okay? So most of the time, we're not gonna put like a plus 2. We're gonna write it down just 2 itself, okay? And for the second one, and this is the second example. So first term is 5x, second term is 7, or I mean, negative 7, I apologize. Because when we look at each term, we always pay attention what sign we have in front of those terms, okay? What sign we have in front of those terms. For example, 5x is a term. What sign it says? Like it's a positive, because that's why we're not gonna write any sign in front of first term. And for the second term, it's 7. But we need to be careful, like what sign it has in front of that 7. So there is a minus sign. So we tell it it's a negative 7, okay? This is the second term. For the last one, the first term is y, but we need to be careful what sign it has in front of them. It's a negative sign, so it's going to be negative y, okay? And for the second term, it's a 3, and we need to pay attention what sign we have in front of them, which is negative sign again. So it will be negative 3, okay? So the terms are part of the expressions, like, and terms are separated by addition and subtraction signs. This is the key thing that you need to know, okay? Expression is, we have like a variable number and operations all together, but when we talk about the term, we have to be go like one by one, by separating with addition and subtraction, okay? So this is about the expression and term. Let's move on the next slide. Okay, so now let's talk about like how we call these terms like one by one. What is a variable, what is a constant, and what is a coefficient? Is that a coefficient, last one? Yes, coefficient. So let me grab my pencil again. Okay, so in the first one, a variable is actually any letter. You don't have to remember the all of this definition. A variable is a letter. Why we use a letter? Because we don't know the value for the things that they are talking about in the word problems. Okay, unknown value. That's why we use a letter. A constant, it's a fixed value, or constant, it's a number that we know the value. It could be like positive or negative. Okay, constant, it's a number that we know the value because it's a number itself and could be positive or negative. The last one, it's a coefficient. Yesterday, I talked about with my hybrid students, they said we don't know about. Actually, a coefficient, it's also a number, but that a number that comes with a variable, okay? So this is the most important thing that you need to remember about coefficient. So coefficient, it's a number multiplied by a variable, or a number that comes in front of the variable. So it's located in front, yes. So let's talk about these now. So this is the first expression, right? And variable is just the letter itself. So that's why I put the X. And for the coefficient, you need to locate first where is the variable. So I'm gonna locate it, it's right here. This is the variable. And the coefficient, it's the number comes in front of it. So the 4, and it's a positive 4, by the way, there is a plus, no sign, which is positive. That's why it's a 4 is the coefficient for this expression. Okay. Or for the first term, I would say. And the constant, it's the number alone, okay? There shouldn't be any variable after that. It has to be alone, a fixed number. So second term is actually the constant because there is no variable. If there is a variable, 2 will become a coefficient. That's why 2 is a constant, number itself, okay? And when you look at the sign in front of the number, it's a positive, so that's why it's a plus 2, or just 2 itself, equal 2, okay? And on the second example, it's obvious that X is a variable because this is the only letter. Sometimes there might be multiple variables, other letters too. So you need to indicate that there is X, Y, Z kind of letters. So for the coefficient, and you need to locate the variable, it's right here, it's X. And the coefficient, it's the number that comes in front of the variable, so which is 5, okay? And for the last one, the constant, so we cannot say 5 is constant because it's with variable and it's a coefficient, we already labeled it. And for the number, constant is the number itself, which is 7. It's alone, there is no variable. And you need to pay attention what sign it has in front of him, which is negative sign. So it's gonna be negative 7, okay? I apologize, students are typing in the chat box. If you guys are trying to participate, I thank you so much, but I cannot check it right now. But when we have a we do part, I'm gonna help you. I will check the chat box, okay? Last one, variable is Y, because there is a letter Y. And coefficient, again, it's the number that comes in front of the variable. So I located my variable, it's Y. And in front of the variable, there is a negative sign. So first of all, there is a no number. If there is a no number, as we talked about yesterday, there is an invisible one, okay? And what kind of one? Because if there is a negative sign, it's gonna become a negative one, okay? So in front of variable, if there is a no number, always assume that it's one, okay? Because as we talked about yesterday, one times something, it's the itself. Like 1 times 9, it's a 9 itself. That's why they're not putting one in front of variables, okay? And the next thing is the constant. So the number itself without variable. So you need to pay attention to the sign in front of that number, which is negative. So it's gonna become negative 3, okay? So this is all about the parts of expressions. These are the parts of expressions, variable, constant, and coefficient, okay? And there is a term. Term means like there is a two term for this expression and all of these examples. So we're gonna move on. And let me clear out this. It is 5D times four. And what happens when D is negative two? So there is a two step. Let's do these. I'm gonna show you the first one. Okay, when you simplify this, everybody agree that 5 times 4 is 20, right? And there is a D. You need to put the D after it. But then, what happens if D is equal negative 2? Which means, instead of D, use a negative 2. So I'm going to put the equal sign after this, and 20 inside of parentheses. When I replace variables with number, I always use a parentheses not to get confused. I recommend for everybody, okay? So 20 times negative 2, what do you think? So this is a 20 times negative 2. All right, you, okay. Somebody says 0, somebody says negative 40D, negative 40 itself, just O letter. Zero, okay. No, it's not a zero, by the way. So you need to multiply the numbers. 20 times two, which is 40. And you're putting negative sign because the first number is positive and second number is negative. As you remember, guys, like positive times negative was negative, right? So that's why it's a negative. And the last thing, you're not putting D because we already replaced that D, this D, with negative two, okay? That's why we're not putting D. So when you plug in these values into D, you're dropping the D because you're using negative two instead of D. Thank you so much. So for the next one, what do you think it will happen? 5R times negative two. What do you think that would happen like when you multiply 5R with negative 2? So we know the fact that we need to multiply numbers first, 5 and negative 2. It's a uh, 10R, but the first number is positive, second number is negative. Opposite sign will result in negative 10R, right? Yes, negative 10R. So the second step, so you need to write it down everything as it is, negative 10, but instead of R, you need to put the empty parentheses and see what you need to put inside of empty parentheses. What is the R equal? R equal negative 3. So in that empty parentheses, you're going to put the 3 and you need to multiply these two now. Yay, you got it. Okay, so first number is negative, second number is negative. Negative times negative, like when you multiply same sign numbers, it becomes positive. And 10 times 3, it's 30. Okay, you don't understand. Let me use another color. Okay, here's the thing. So did you listen to the beginning of the lesson? Yes or no? Okay, so we're talking about multiplying expressions or terms. So for example, the 5R, it's a term, right? It's not, there is a no plus something or it's just a single term. And negative two, it's also a term because there is a no other term. I mean, other term to say it expression. So when you multiply, I would recommend use a headset if you cannot hear it. I think we have the same problem yesterday with you. So when you multiply two terms, you just need to multiply the numbers. In the second example, I multiplied 5 with negative 2. So when I multiply 5 with negative 2, it became negative 10. Okay. And then right next to number, you need to put the variable, whatever the variable you have. So that's why I put the R. And R comes right after the number. So the next step, I need to look at it. Is R equal something? So in the instruction, it says R equal negative 3. So instead of R, I need to replace with negative 3. So how you do that? You need to write it down negative 10 as it is, times, instead of r, I put the empty parentheses. Inside of these empty parentheses, I put the value of r, which is negative 3. That's why I put the inside of parentheses negative 3, because r is equal negative 3, okay? And the last thing, you need to multiply negative 10 with negative 3. So I know the fact that when I multiply same sign numbers, which is negative times negative, it's a positive. If you guys remember, when two negative comes together, it becomes positive. That's why it's positive. And you just need to multiply the numbers, 10 times 3, which is 30. Is that clear? Kinda. So if it's kinda, we're gonna move on. Like we need to do more practices until we get the point of this, okay? So for the next one, I'm gonna give you a little bit advanced one, okay? So for example, there are two terms now. Look at this. This is the first term and it's separated by this addition, and this is the second term. The reason why I use these parentheses to like show you guys clearly it's a term, because between negative 2 and 7c, there is a no plus or minus sign. There is a multiplication sign, okay? That's why it's a single term. And now you need to simplify these terms. So for 3b and 8, you need to multiply 8 and 3, right? Because there is a multiplication. If there is a no sign between them, it's a multiplication. So 8 times 3, it's a... Oh, you, okay, just to hold on, because we need to go step by step. 24b, it becomes... 8 times 3, it's a 24, and there is a variable b. That's why I need to put the b right next to it. And in between, there is a plus sign. I'm going to put the plus sign, and I'm going to simplify now the second term. So there is a number 7 and negative 2. What happens if you multiply 7 with negative 2? 7 times 2, it's a 14. By the way, I'm going to use a parenthesis for the second term to not to get confused. So 7 times 2, it's a, yes, it's a negative 14. Thank you. Because negative times positive, it's a negative. And you need to put the letter right next to it. There is a C variable. I'm going to put the C right here. Okay. For the next step, this is the step one. The next step, you need to look at it. Which values are equal for these variables? So B equal 2 and C equal 3. I'm going to write it down these terms now without variable, but instead of variable, I'm going to put the empty parentheses. So because I need to replace those variables with something. So instead of B, I put the empty parentheses plus, and for negative 14, and let me separate these parentheses now. And for C, I'm going to put, I'm going to put empty parentheses. Okay, right here. So now inside of these empty parentheses, I'm going to put those values. And so B, it's equal negative 2. So instead of B, I'm going to put the negative 2. Oh, not negative 2. I apologize. Let's go back. Okay, it's a 2 itself. So 2. And instead of C, so look at it. It's a 3. So instead of C, I'm going to put the number 3 now. So now you have a number expression. So first you need to do the multiplication for 24 times 2. Somebody already told me it's a 48, and it's going to be 48 plus, and the second number is second multiplication is negative 14 times 3. Yes, it is a negative 42. So I'm going to use a parenthesis because it's a negative number, negative 42. So last step is now 48 plus negative 42. What do you think? Yay. Okay. Thank you so much. It's 6. So if you use your calculator, or if you use the subtraction, 48 minus 42, it's a 6. Thank you so much. You guys are so awesome. Okay. So this is kind of problems that we will be doing today. And let me see if you have more practices. Yeah, it is 6. Thank you. So okay, that's it. This is today's practice, but don't worry about it. If you're not clearly get this, we're gonna practice on these kind of problems on IXL next week, okay? This week is just a review for everything like expressions, terms and stuff. we need to know first the vocabulary of these unit. That's why we'll keep practicing vocabulary. Okay, so now this is the end of the instruction time and we finished the we do part. Now it's the you do part. So you guys need to click this, try to finish up on the vocabulary. Two things. Number one, the video. Number two, vocab cards, vocab game. I mean, not cards, vocab game. So you need to finish up those two of them. Don't forget them, okay? And after you're finished, there is an exit ticket. And I will remind us at the end of the classroom, we still have time. So there is a one problem about finding an addition of these two. It's a review from yesterday, okay? And it's the same checklist that you did yesterday. See if you still understand this, okay? So yeah, I'm gonna give you now around 10 minutes because we